Hi guys, happy Sunday. So as you know, there is no Sunday school this week and probably for the next few weeks because of coronavirus. But we want to let you guys know, like, just even though there's no Sunday school, like, we're still here for you. So, like, if you need anything during the week or anything like that, like, please reach out to us. We're not, like, your servants aren't just going to go away because of all of this, okay? So instead of doing Sunday school this week, we're just going to do a short video. I'm just going to do a short video about the next saint on our list. So if you guys remember, or if you were there last week, we did Pope Carolus, and Natalie gave a really nice lesson about, like, his miracles and his life and who he was. And this week we're going to do Abouna Bishoy Kamel. And I want you guys to know that, like, the point of these lessons and the point of doing this is for us to be able to, one, understand the lives of these saints, and, like, get to know them more. So, like, when we use them in our intercessions, we know who we're talking to. And, like, if you think about it, we use intercessions all the time, like, in church. And the liturgy on a day-to-day basis, even when you say to someone, like, oh, pray for me, like, that's technically an intercession. Okay, and the second reason is because we want to be able to learn from them. We want to be able to learn from their example. So Abouna Bishoy Kamel was born in Egypt, and he was born to a Christian family and went to school, went to college, became a teacher after college. And he loved teaching, like, loved it so much, to the point where he was, like, really into Sunday school service because he loved teaching so much. So, like, not only was it his career, but he did it in Sunday school as well. And he was known for being a great Sunday school teacher. And eventually he was ordained as a priest in Alexandria, and his church was in Alexandria. And he started a new church in Alexandria, actually. The problem was the church had so many people that it was really hard for him to keep up. So he ended up pushing for the ordination of five priests. So it was like him and four other priests at that church. And at the time, like, there was this thing where, like, it kind of, like, wasn't a good look to, like, ordain more priests at your church because, like, priests, like, wanted the church to themselves. Like, oh, like, I want to be in control. Like, I want to make all the rules. I want to be, like, the one that everybody looks up to. And so people would be like, Abouna Bishoy, like, why do you want more priests? Like, don't you want to be, like, the big boss? Like, don't you want to be, like, the man in charge? And he was like, no, like, I want the people to be happy, and I want, like, things to go well for the people, to the point that they ended up getting four new priests. So they had five total, which at that time in Egypt was, like, unheard of, like, because, like, people would, like, priests were, like, kind of known to, like, get upset if they weren't, like, in charge. There were, like, some problems in that area. So he's a good example for priests and congregations in that. And then eventually, in the late 60s, he came to the United States, and he came to Los Angeles in California. And like that, so in the 60s, like, there was barely any Coptic people in the US. There were barely any churches. So it was all very brand new. But he did, like, the majority of his service here in the US, starting in the late 60s, okay? So probably at that time, like, some of your parents were, like, just starting to be born, okay? So he's, like, a pretty recent guy. Like, this isn't, like, someone, like, many, many, many years ago, okay? And over there, like, he was also, like, known for, like, both in Egypt and the U.S., he was, like, also known for, like, doing some miracles. One story that I heard that I thought was really nice is, like, he always told people, like, you know, like, don't worry about money. Like, don't worry about, like, what's going to happen. Like, you'll be fine. Like, God will take care of you. You'll be fine. So one day, like, this girl came up to him and was like, oh, like, I really need some money. Like, I'm not, like, doing well. Like, the things are going really bad. And then this other guy came in right after her, and he was like, oh, like, I really need some money. Like, things are going really poorly, and I need help. And so Abouna Bishoy didn't say anything to them. He was just like, okay, like, let's just wait here and see, okay? A couple of minutes later, this little girl walks into the church and hands Abouna Bishoy an envelope. And, like, the Abouna Bishoy and the two people who came to ask him for money were like, who are you? Where did you come from? And all she said was, my mother, Mary, asked me to give this envelope to you and told to tell you it's from her. And he opened the envelope, and it was the exact amount of money that man and that woman were asking for. So he gave the man what he was asking for and the woman. And so, like, that little girl, like, when she was talking about, like, her mother, Mary, that was Saint Mary, like, sent them the money that they needed. So it was, like, a good lesson for those people to learn, like, don't worry about whatever you need. Like, God will provide you with what you need. And then one time when he was in America and they were just starting the church, they were, like, praying. They didn't really have a church, so they were just, like, praying here and there. And if you guys know, like, Los Angeles, like, where the church was, is, like, not an easy place to find land. It's not easy to find buildings. Like, it's very difficult. It's very crowded. So eventually they ended up finding this building, and they had to pay $100,000 for the building, which at the time, I mean, it's still a lot of money, but at the time that was, like, a lot of money. It was, like, very difficult to have that much money. But they found it, and they, like, fundraised, and they barely, like, just barely fundraised enough money to get for the down payment of the church. So when you buy a piece of property, like, you buy a house or you buy a church or something like that, you pay, like, the bank a small percentage of how much it costs. And then after that, like, over the years, you'll make more payments until you, like, finished paying it off. So, like, they barely had enough money, and they, like, raised it in cash. So Abouna Bishoy took all the cash. He had it in his car. He had it in, like, this envelope, and he was going to the bank to give the money to the bank and to sign, like, the loan to buy the church. So he calls a cab, like a taxi. He gets in the taxi with his envelope of money, and he goes to the bank. And then when he gets to the bank, he realizes he left the envelope inside the car, inside the taxi, because, like, at the end of the process, like, the lady at the bank was like, okay, now it's time for you to give me the down payment. And he looks and he's like, oh, I don't have it. And then he realized he probably left it in the taxi. And it was, like, going to be impossible for him to find it. Like, how is he going to find it? Like, the guy in the taxi, it's cash. So it's not even, like, a check, like, a big check or something that you can trace. It was all cash in an envelope that had no markings on it. So it was, like, going to be impossible to find and really easy for someone to steal. So Abouna Bishoy goes home, and he's, like, worried because he thinks, like, the people in the church are going to think that he stole all the money. But, like, he always said to people, like, don't worry, like, God will always provide. God will always provide, okay? So then the same day, this was in the morning, so the same day at, like, midnight, him and his wife hear a knocking on the apartment door. And so his wife answers the door, and it's the cab driver. And the cab driver was like, I found this money in my car. It was, like, an envelope of, like, it was, like, $25,000, which was a ton of money. It's a ton of money now, but it was way more money back then. That's, like, a salary, like, for a whole year. $25,000, and I, like, was going to keep it. And I felt really conflicted, and I kept going back and forth. Like, should I keep it? Should I keep it? And, like, something told me it was wrong. Like, I shouldn't keep it. Like, this is, like not the right thing to do. So he kept asking around, like, who could the strange man be that was in my car? And he was asking around all day, like, from the morning until, like, nighttime, to find out who could this man be that left the money in the car, and how am I going to get a hold of him? Like, he didn't leave, like, there was like no credit card, there was no check, like there was no information for him to track down Abouna Bishoy. So like by some miracle, he talked to enough people to find out who Abouna Bishoy was, find out where he lived, and he returned all the money and they were able to buy the church. So that was another miracle. And another thing is that Abouna Bishoy had cancer. And like, instead of like being upset about cancer, he actually saw it as a blessing. And he actually has written a book about his struggle with cancer. And he always said, like, this is a blessing because, like, I'm able to, like, experience, like, trials and, like, not focus on, like, things of this earth. And everyone was always like, whoa, like, Abouna Bishoy, how can you, like, say that? How can you say that? And he always told people, like, you need to not focus on things of this world so much, but to focus on things above. And so that's a good lesson for us, because even when he was faced with so many trials, when things seemed to go really bad, when things were really difficult, he always just trusted God. And especially now for us during this time, it's really important for us to learn from him and to learn from his example, that whenever we feel like something's going to go wrong, like, we just need to trust in God, and we need to believe that God will always provide. So if you have a hard time these next couple of weeks believing that, as I know I do, it's good to ask for the intercessions of Abouna Bishoy Kamel, who will help you with that. So that's it for this week. Stay tuned. We will try to make sure that we're keeping you guys, like, involved and up to date as much as possible, even if we can't have like events and stuff going on. Again, feel free to call any of your servants, like if you have comments or questions about the lesson or anything else.